got to win the game to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite, when you're coming to take your freedoms away.
Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. You know, I was just on Twitter chatting with one of the anonymous members of the Op Liberation movement. If you don't know about that, that's the movement that is fighting to stop the torture of our teens under the flag of behavior modification, troubled teen, etc., etc. And they asked, see, they've been taking action right along here. And the question is a very good question. We know these kids are being tortured anyway, and now there's a big online movement to shut these places down. We want to know if the children are being punished beyond what is normal because of DDoS attacks or other online actions against places like Diamond Ranch Academy or any of the other. There's 101 of them, or how many ever there is. There's too many to list torturing our teens, you know. That's a good question. And it got my mind thinking, you know, that we need to get somebody inside. And my first thought was, you know, somebody that's a teen, that's tech savvy, that could get into one of these places and give us constant information. But it would be very hard. I know the situation in those camps, and those kids are, some of them 90 days with no contact with family at all. It's brutal, folks. If you don't know about this movement, you need to get active with it, please. They're fighting for our kids. Okay, the leaders are the next generation to lead this country, the teens of today. And they're being brutalized for money. So, we're going to have a live show in a couple of weeks. So I'll link you to the video that explains the time and the links of that. If you don't know about this movement, it would be a great time to get yourself informed. But I'm going to call for an anonymous activist who can acquire a job at one of these facilities and who would get this information and get inside information about the way these kids are treated. So far, to my knowledge, not a lot of the workers have come forward. And many times the workers, the counselors, are kids that were brutalized themselves that have turned into counselors after the fact. So they're already brainwashed in getting that, you know, that recognition that they never got. But it's, you know, it's not good recognition, folks. Kids are being brutalized daily, and we need to get busy with it. We need to get busy. We need to get somebody inside at one of these many institutions. I don't have a full list for you now. But if it strikes your heart that this needs to be done, remember, any information that you can get to us, you will remain anonymous with myself or others, and I will help you in any way that I can. We need to get inside, we need to get information out, we need to stop this brutalization of our teens. Much love, many thanks. The link to the video description of the upcoming show that will tell you more about this industry and tell you about the upcoming convention for the survivors of institutional abuse, and that's a great going to be a great show, especially if you are a survivor. There's a big network out there to support you, and if you're one of those kids that may be thinking that you're going to end up going there, just remember you got a whole family fighting for you. Much love, many thanks, and I'll see you back with you, human beings. While the first portion of this video was processing, an anonymous party with the Op Liberation movement asked me to share this information, and I was glad to do it because a lot of you aren't getting it, I don't think, on how important this movement is. Okay, this is a Stop SEMA campaign, but this, some of the things that I'm about to read to you happen over and over and over and over in institutions all across this country. And as adults, we have a responsibility to protect the children. Period. End of discussion. No more needed. Period. And normally, folks, you know, I'll show you a post. I'll give you my take on it. And I don't usually read everything to you because I want you to get off your ass and read it yourself. And I do. But I also want you to hear this. If you can hear what I'm about to read to you, and you can still sit there and know that this is going on in your country, that there are teens being tortured, and you can sit there and take that and not do anything about it, then I hope all those evils befall you. Anyway, for anyone that does not already know, St. Lucie, Florida Circuit Court Judge Robert Bellinger has granted Alan Weirman until 2014 to obtain the proper accreditation to remain open despite pleas by the Florida Department of Children and Family Services citing abuse and neglect. The ruling is outrageous due to the fact that in 2011, Weirman was ordered to do the same thing by Judge Dan Vaughn in a timely manner. Almost 2 years later, the colonel has still failed to be able to obtain state accreditation due to unsafe conditions, lack of proper staffing, and repeated reports of abuse and neglect. Now see right here, I just asked you in the first portion of this video, we need an inn. And this place is going to need proper staffing. So this may play into to somebody's availability. Just pointing that out. Anyway, moving along. This conundrum leads us to believe that there is a level of corruption and back-scratching going on behind the scenes, and as any good Anon knows, we do not tolerate corruption and the abuse of innocent victims. The local government in Port Luce should expect us. In a short bio, Judge Robert Bellinger, he was appointed to his position in 2004 by Jeb Bush and has been elected unstopped since then, which is worthy to be looked into as to why. His educational history consists of graduating from John Carroll University in 1981. He then received his judicial degree from the Cleveland Marshall College of Law in 1986. Ballinger was accepted to Duke to obtain his Master's of Law in 2012. It seems to me his educational history is lacking for his position. It makes me curious as to why he was appointed. It also is important to note that Bellinger is a former Marine. While I support the good soldiers in our military, he might not be objective enough to try this case, which involves child abuse at a military-style institute. While good old Jeb Bush found it suitable to put Bellinger on the stand, there are others that would disagree. According to TheRobinRoom.com, a website devoted to judging the corrupt within the judicial system, Bellinger always has his mind made up prior to any trial. Totally incompetent, mind made up prior to trial. If there's any chance to ever supplant him from his place in line at the public teat, I will be there to holler from the highest treetop, unknown. Even further in the infuriating... according to a defense attorney local to Bellinger who has worked with him, forget about getting an impartial judge in a criminal case. He prosecutes from the bench. I've never seen him give bond or reduce bond. State never has to worry because he literally researched the case law for them. I have found two fourth DCA cases which remanded the case with specific directions that he no longer preside over the case. In one case, they quoted Arsenio Hall when they saw Bellinger's incredible findings of fact in a suppression hearing, things that make you go, complete discredit to the bench, will not give the defense any meaningful ruling. So in conclusion, Judge Robert Bellinger has appointed himself judge, jury, and executioner in any case he presides over. He had an obligation to protect the abused and tortured children at SEMA, and he failed. Therefore, we have judged him unfit to offer any ruling on SEMA. Let's give him a call and tell him so. Use your voice, sweet and gentle hooligans, since the children in clutches of the Colonel Death at his camp of horrors cannot use theirs. We are their heroes. Let's not disappoint them. And here's all the judge's information. Folks, I'm going to link you to this post so you can come copy and paste this information. But I want you to hear more because there is more. And the more should also horrify you. You're a bad man, Colonel. Alan Weirman, the self-proclaimed Colonel, parades in army fatigues to instill misplaced respect and fear into those around him. Alan, you aren't fit to represent our military. Alan does this to help perpetrate his campaign of control in his Academy of Horror. The Colonel also claims to have a PhD but can offer no verification of his higher education. Even further into the disturbing, Alan's adolescent years were spent in a troubled teen institute called Brinkhaven, where he met his future wife Molly and later became an employee. William Brink was Molly's father, who founded the institution, which was later closed when Willie was convicted of raping his wife and Molly. During his marriage to Molly and what inevitably ended his employment at Brinkhaven, Allen was accused of sexually abusing a minor who was incarcerated there 30 times over a period of 1 year. All this is detailed in the link below. Victory Forge was an offshoot institution of Brinkhaven, which was taken over by Molly and Allen. Below is a link to the program staff information for VF and why it is investigated in 2008, when a runaway from the facility was found with metal shackles around their ankles. Pictured is one of ex-students' account of their pain from VF. It was the investigation in 2008 that prompted Allen to change the name to Southeastern Military Academy to continue his reign of terror over teens, costing concerned parents hundreds of thousands of dollars, as well as being a sadistic, sexually abusive, narcissistic, lying manipulator. Allen is also a racist. A judge recently ruled to give SEMA another year and so many months until June 2014 to obtain the appropriate accreditation to stay open. That means they have that much more time to torture and kill teens. They must be stopped. Please spread this blog and any other means of awareness to help us save the lives of helpless teens left in Colonel's death clutches. Folks, this is the real deal. This is not propaganda because somebody's mad. I have done several live shows on this, and links to those old shows going back a year and a half ago or 2 years ago, if you want to check those out. But you can get up and current and just jump in there now. You don't have to go listen to the old stuff. Support the Op Liberation tag and stop SEMA. I want to read you this as well. SEMA should expect us. The material contained within this blog may be graphic and cause extreme emotional distress. Unfortunately, this reaction is necessary to save a demographic of children who are being abused, raped, neglected, spiritually destroyed, and in some cases murdered. The TTI industry has been using the pain and misery of misled parents and teenagers for profit. The specific facility that this blog will be focusing on is called Southeastern Military Academy, specializing in paramilitary training and religious worship. The children are pushed to extreme lengths, endangering their lives because they have been labeled as troubled teens by parents who have sent them to this institute. Below is a link to their website. This academy is really just a torture chamber for developing and misunderstood teens, parading as a military educational facility with a religious background. It is this fake religious persona that protects this facility from being shut down by the state. Thanks to Alexandra Zays, Kathleen Flynn, and Anonymous, SEMA should expect us. Stories of broken bones, illness, abuse, and death are surfacing from teens who managed to survive the brutalization they were exposed to. Please follow the links below to see for yourself and stay tuned for this blog for updates. Going to link you to the blogs, folks. This stuff is going on. This isn't the only camp, so this is the focus today. This needs to be stopped immediately. They all need to be stopped. We need to support this tag on Twitter, Op Liberation. I don't care who you are. If you can stand the thought of any teenager, whether they want to be labeled as a troubled teen or not, okay, probably just a normal growth process. You've got to stand up. You can't sit there. These are your kids. These are our kids. And yes, SEMA should expect us all. So keep my idea in mind, folks. We need to get somebody working in these camps, creating a concise list, and finding people that can find employment within these places who will wear microphones, recording devices, video recording, photographs, whatever you can come up with. We got to shut them down. We got to stop them. Anyway, much love, many thanks. Link to this blog will be below. And I think there's another link I have to give you. Let me refresh my mind. I guess not. Anyway, much love, many thanks. Op Liberation, expect.